Hello, this is Larry Joe Starkey with the American Quarter Horse Journal, as versatile as the breed. We're here at the 2014 AQHA World Championship Show, and last night we were treated to a wonderful demonstration of para-reining. We loved it, so did the crowd, and we wanted to find out more about para-reining and what it means. We're here today with Brad Ettleman, Acting Executive Director of USA Reining. Brad, what is para-reining?
So para-reining is it's a program of sport that's designed to be parallel to able-bodied reining for riders with disabilities. In this case, it's para-reining, a discipline within the international movement for reining.
How does it compare to para-dressage? A lot of our para-reiners last night were from the para-dressage world.
Well, comparatively, as far as a discipline, there's a lot in common. You know, dressage and reining both use a prescribed pattern. Every horse that comes in the arena does exactly the same thing. But as far as culture, it couldn't be any more different. Reining comes from a ranching sort of heritage, and dressage comes from, you know, a 500-year-old tradition of military movements. So while it may be similar in the arena, it's vastly different culturally and as a sport.
USA Reining, AQHA, NRHA, USPEA, that's a lot of letters. What do they all mean? Can you sort that out for us?
It's a difficult question, but fairly easy to answer. It is a lot of letters out there. USA Reining is the official sport organization. It's the official affiliate for the sport of reining within the United States. And we report to our parent organization, which is the United States Equestrian Federation. And then that reports up to the International Equestrian Federation, also referred to as the FEI. United States Para-Equestrian Association is the official affiliate for para. And so they're our sister organization. We work hand in glove with them when it comes to para-reining. I think everybody watching this knows what AQHA means. NRHA is also a partner of ours in our efforts to advance para-reining forward. And am I leaving any acronym out that I can think of? No, I think I covered them all.
Could you tell us about efforts to make para-reining an international discipline?
Sure, yeah. So we started the effort to bring reining into the para equestrian fold at this very event last year in 2013 with the kickoff para-reining demonstration. And we spent all of 2014 having demonstration events where we could get riders who are not only accomplished riders within para-dressage, but also riders who are more Western-type riders exposed to and familiar with para-competitions. And then we're ending that demonstration year here again at the 2014 World Show. And so it's been a very lucrative year. We've also launched a research study where we are investigating what movements per maneuver a person needs to make in order to compete in reining, and then how that relates to each person's potential disability, what disabilities rate into which category so that it's a fair competition.
And now para-dressage is divided into different categories based on ability. Do we see that happening in para-reining in the future?
Yes. So the first thing that we do in any para sport, whether it be equestrian sports or, you know, any of the Olympic sports, is that we establish what the rider or the athlete's disability is. And then that's classified into one of 48 different classifications about physical use of body and also mental classifications. From there, just like in dressage and any other equestrian sport, we then grade the riders from 1 to 4 based on their level of disability. And it's not about quality, so a grade 1 rider isn't any less capable than a grade 4 rider. It's just that they have more limitations physically. And so we'd like for them to compete on an even playing field with riders who have similar disabilities to their own.
Internationally, can we expect to see para-reining at the Paralympics in Brazil in 2016?
I think that we have more of a long-term goal with para-reining. We should not expect to see para-reining included in the Paralympics in Rio. Tokyo is a much more realistic opportunity. But even then, those of us in governance and those of us trying to get the program implemented into international sport, we're not really in a rush to get to the Paralympics. We'd rather do it right than be rushed and get to the Olympics. We'd rather have our programs be developed and be developed smartly so that they have a lasting and enduring legacy. And so while Paralympics would be ideal for a sport like para-reining, that's not our ultimate goal. However, it is a goal, so keep an eye out for it, maybe not in the near future.
Last night after the competition, I heard some of the para-reiners saying, I can't wait to get my own horse. Would you agree that the American Quarter Horse is the best horse for para-reining?
Yeah, I don't think you can say that any better. I think that most of the riders we had here at this demonstration came over from dressage. They're all very accomplished riders. They've been to the Paralympics before, including London and so forth. And they are national champions. They're on the FEI ranking list. So they're accomplished equestrians. And just as you said, when they stepped off their horses after riding the first time, you heard a lot of comments like, I love this. This is really cool. You're going to convert me. I love reining. And I think a lot of that, we have to tip our hat once again to the American Quarter Horse. I think that the Quarter Horse is perfect for any kind of disabled riding program, especially para-reining, where we're competing at the high performance level. I think the Quarter Horse is safe. I think it's sound. I think it's perfect for this kind of activity. They take care of their riders. They're smart. There's no better breed for para-reining than the American Quarter Horse.
There you heard it. Para-reining and the American Quarter Horse, a perfect combination.